Welcome back. My name is Lucy. I'm a pharmacist and a nurse. And in this video, we'll talk about monkeypox. What is monkeypox? What causes it? Symptoms? How to prevent it? And its treatment. What is monkeypox? Monkeypox is an other pox virus, which is in the same family of viruses that include smallpox. It is a double-stranded DNA virus. It is a viral zoonotic infection. Viral zoonotic infections are infections that are transmissible from animals other than humans to people. It has a rash that is similar to smallpox. There are two strains of monkeypox, the Western and Central African strain. In comparison to the strain isolated in Central Africa, Western African strain is less virulent and less lethal. The Central African strain has a 10% death rate compared to 1 to 3% death rate in the Western African strain. This picture shows the recent monkeypox outbreak in Europe and North America. So the cases have been reported in United States, Canada, United Kingdom, Spain, Portugal, Italy, and Sweden. Where does monkeypox virus come from? According to CDC, the virus was identified in 1950s from a colony of sick monkeys. In 1970, monkeypox was identified as a cause of disease in humans in Democratic Republic of Congo. Between 1970 and 1980, 59 cases were reported with a mortality rate of 17%. All of these cases occurred in the rainforest of Western and Central Africa. The cases were linked to individuals who were exposed to small forest animals like rodents, squirrels, and monkeys. The first outbreak in Western Hemisphere occurred in United States in 2003. The 2003 monkeypox outbreak was linked to prairie dog. The prairie dog appeared to have acquired the virus from African rodents when the two species were housed at a distribution center in Illinois. How does monkeypox spread? It can spread through animal to human. Animal to human transmission can happen either by petting infected animal, coming in contact with their bodily fluid by either a bite or a scratch, and through consuming meat of infected animal. In Africa, evidence of monkeypox virus infection has been found in many types of animals, including rope squirrels, tree squirrels, dormice, bat, rodent, and different pieces of monkeys. Monkeypox can also spread through human-to-human transmission. Human-to-human transmission is limited and requires close contact with skin lesion of infected person or contaminated objects like clothes and linen. Also, human-to-human transmission can happen through large respiratory droplet, but this requires a prolonged face-to-face contact. The prolonged face-to-face contact is considered within 6-foot radius for 3 or more hours in absence of personal protection equipment. This is a depiction of monkeypox transmission in Central Africa. As you can see, the primary host is rodent and monkeys are incidental hosts. The next step is bushmeat hunting. So people hunting bushmeat so that they can eat it, and then it goes to human, and then these humans can transmit to other humans, which is that is considered secondary transmission. The CDC and the World Health Organization put out the statement below, which I'm going to read it out. Monkeypox, a viral zoonotic infection, is endemic in certain parts of Africa. Cases outside of Africa have typically been linked to international travel or imported animals. However, in May 2022, multiple clusters of monkeypox have been reported in non-endemic areas, including countries in Europe and North America. Most cases have been identified in men who have sex with men. Person-to-person transmission can occur through large respiratory droplets and by direct contact with body fluids or lesional material. In this outbreak, close contact with infectious skin lesion during sexual contact may be likely mode of transmission. Even though most of the cases have been linked to men who have sex with men, anyone can contract monkeypox via close contact with infected skin, beddings, clothes, or objects used by someone with an active infection. How long is the monkeypox incubation period? So the classical incubation period is usually 6 to 13 days, but it can range from 5 to 21 days. So the incubation period depends on the mode of transmission. So if it's for biting or scratching, the incubation period will be shorter compared to other tactical exposure, like touching the lesions or clothes of infected person. What are the symptoms of monkeypox? The illness begins with with fever, so a temperature greater than or equal to 38.5 degrees Celsius or 101.3 degrees Fahrenheit, headache, muscle ache, backache, swollen lymph nodes, chills, exhaustion, and finally, the rash. In humans, symptoms of monkeypox are similar to smallpox but milder. The main difference between symptoms of smallpox and monkeypox is that monkeypox causes lymph nodes to swell while smallpox does not. These symptoms usually last between 2 to 4 weeks. And this table is just an overview of the monkeypox symptoms. As you can see, the patient doesn't have any symptoms during the incubation period or during the recovery period. This table shows the incidence of monkeypox symptoms. These incidences are based on 2003 outbreak in the United States. As you can see, 83% of the patients experienced rash in 2003. About 73% of the patient had fever, and you can see all the other incidences on the table. Monkeypox rash appears 1 to 5 days after the first symptom. The rash often begins on the face, then spreads elsewhere on the body, including palms of the hands and soles of the feet. The rash starts off as raised spots forming into fluid blisters, then scabs, which falls off. The lesions can be itchy and painful. The rash goes through all these stages before scabbing and falling off. The rash can also resemble chickenpox or syphilis. This picture down here, that's just a depiction of the different stages of the rash. And on this picture right here, this is just showing where the rash has scabbed up and fallen off. And this right here is a fluid-filled blister. How to diagnose monkeypox? So diagnosing monkeypox is not easy, and different criteria have to be looked at before a final diagnosis is made. Have to look at the clinical features. So for that, you're looking at the rash and the other symptoms just to see how they look. Does it meet the criteria of monkeypox? The second thing is epidemiologic data. You want to see where has this patient been within the last 21 days. Has they been in contact with dead or live wild animal or exotic pet? You have to look at the laboratory data. Has there been any detection of other poxvirus DNA? And lastly, you have to consider other differential diagnoses like herpes, smallpox, other poxviruses, varicella, or shingles. And this is a diagnosis criteria that has been put out by the CDC. And these are the things you look at before confirming that the patient has monkeypox. And if a diagnosis of monkeypox is being considered, local and state public health officials, along with CDC, should be notified so that the samples can be quickly processed. What are the treatment options for monkeypox? Most patients have mild disease and recover without medical intervention, but some patients might need supportive care. These patients include patients with nausea, vomiting, and difficulty swallowing. They may require short hospital stay for intravenous fluid. There are some antiviral medications that are available for treatment of monkeypox, and the antiviral treatment may be reasonable for patients with severe disease and those at risk for severe disease. These include patients who are immunocompromised, pregnant, breastfeeding, and those younger than 8 years of age. The first antiviral medication is tocovirimat or TPO. This medication is available in IV or oral formula. Tocovirimat, it's an inhibitor of other poxvirus protein, and it was approved for treatment of chickenpox in United States in July of 2018. The dose is based on patient's weight, and the treatment is for 14 days. The next medication is brincidofovir. This was approved for treatment of smallpox in United States in June of 2021. It is only available in oral formulation, and like tocovirimat, the dose depends on the patient's weight. For brincidofovir, the patient only need 2 doses. Tocovirimat and brincidofovir are only available through the CDC, and the decision to use antivirals should be made in consultation with local health department and the CDC. The third medication is sidofovir. Sidofovir is not approved by the FDA for smallpox or monkeypox, but for treatment of cytomegalovirus retinitis. However, sidofovir has shown some activity against monkeypox in laboratory studies. Sidofovir should be used in caution because it can cause severe kidney failure. How can we prevent monkeypox transmission? The transmission can be prevented through pre-exposure prophylaxis. This includes infection control precautions, avoiding contact with animals that could harbor the virus, including animals that are sick or that have been found dead in areas where monkeypox occurs, a avoiding contact with any materials such as bedding that have been in contact with sick animal, isolating infected patients from others who could be a risk for infection, practicing good hand hygiene after contact with infected animals or humans, and use of personal protective equipment when caring for patients who have monkeypox. There are also some vaccines that are available for monkeypox. The first vaccine is ACAM2000. It is a replication component smallpox vaccine that was approved for use in the United States in 2007. Since ACAM2000 is a live vaccine, it is contraindicated in immunocompromised patients. The next vaccine is Jynneos. It is a replication deficient modified vaccinia Ankara vaccine. It protects against monkeypox and smallpox, and it was approved by the FDA in 2019 for adults age 18 and older. Jynneos vaccine is made from highly attenuated, non-replicating vaccinia virus, and for that reason, it has an excellent safety profile even in immunocompromised patients. Jynneos is manufactured by Bavarian Nordic, and according to Bavarian Nordic, the United States ordered millions of vaccine doses in 2020 for national stockpile. For post-exposure prophylaxis, we can use vaccinia virus vaccine, so that is the ACAM2000 or Jynneos. According to CDC, the optimal time for monkeypox post-exposure vaccine is within 4 days, but the vaccine can be considered for up to 14 days of a close contact exposure. The next post-exposure prophylaxis for prevention of monkeypox is vaccinia immunoglobulin intravenous. These are antibodies obtained from human plasma of individual immunized with the smallpox vaccine and provide passive immunity. The use of vaccinia immunoglobulin may be considered in immunocompromised patients with an exposure history and who are not a candidate for Jynneos vaccine. Thirdly, for post-exposure prophylaxis is infection control precautions. So use of standard contact, droplet, and airborne precautions are recommended for any generalized vesicular rash of unknown etiology in which monkeypox and smallpox are included in the differential diagnosis. What should you do if you think you have monkeypox? So you should isolate. According to CDC, you should isolate until all lesions are healed and new skin is formed. You should seek medical advice and you should call your local health office or in the CDC. This table shows the reported cases in United States as of June 2nd, 2022. So far in United States, there have been 21 confirmed cases, and this is as of June 2nd, 2022. Here are my references, and I have included them in the description box below. Thank you for watching. Like and share the video, and subscribe to the channel if you found this information helpful.